he is my favorite writer. Reading his book always feels like an adventure, and I would be like, oh my god, why has he written all these things? I love him. I just love him. I think we all have a favorite writer, someone whose book we love, whose writing we love, and whose book we just don't want to miss out. We are so sure of how they write and what they write about that we'll just buy their book just by their name. That's all. We don't even need to know the title of the book or what the book is about or read any reviews of that book before getting it. And for me, that's none other than Malcolm Gladwell. He is my favorite. He is my favorite writer. If I get to meet him and, you know, just talk to him, then I would be like, oh my god, I just hope that happens one day. I mean, he's amazing. The way he writes, the way he think about things, and the way he explain things and things unfold, and you start knowing so many different things. I just love him, and I really want to meet him one day. I will, I guess, hopefully. So we kind of drifted off the point there, and I started talking all about Gladwell. So let's get back to the point, and let's get this video back on track. So in this video, I'm going to talk about three books that I have read by him, and yeah, we are going to talk about them. There are many other books by him, and it's not that I don't want to read them. Obviously, I do. I want to read each and every one of them, all the new books that he writes. But the problem here is that there's only limited number of books, and I was really reading them fast. I was completing all his books. These three I read back to back. So I thought, you know, then the list is going to get exhausted. Then I won't have that pleasure of reading his book. So what will I do then? How will I survive? So yeah, I made a conscious decision that I will space his books out. I won't be just reading them back to back. I would take my sweet time reading them. I would read his one book, then take some time, read other books, then read his book, then again take a time out, then read his book. That is how I'm going to devour his books. I'm really going to, you know, properly give them the time they deserve and really space them out over the time. So that is the only reason that is holding me back from buying his books, because I know once I get them, I'm going to read them. There's no stopping me then. Once I have his book, I am going to pick it up and read it. So I have not even bought them. That, you know, I have bought them and put them in my shelf, I will read later. That is not going to happen. I'm going to pick it up and read it. I do not have that amount of self-control. So yeah, but I will get his book soon and read them all. So basically, I'm recording this video for the second time, because first time I did everything. I gushed about his books, I gushed over him, and I told all about it. And guess what? I did not press record.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
I mean, let's take a moment. I had to re-record everything. I had to say all the things all over again, and it was very frustrating. You know, the first time when you really want to say all these things, so there's so much and you say everything, but second time that, you know, spark really dims. So if you find me in a little less energy in this video, you know the reason for that.
I am sorry.
Okay, so the first book that I read of his was The Tipping Point. I just thought it is another book because I used to see this one a lot on Instagram, other people's account, and in all the lists that I used to do a lot of research, books for that, books for this book, that book, books to read before 20, books to read before you die, all these kind of lists, and I used to see this pretty often, so I ordered it. I did not really had any expectations from this book, and I had no idea that Gladwell is going to become such. Oh god, let's skip that part. But yeah, so basically I just got this book with no expectations, and as I started reading this one, initially it was a bit dull because I was not really able to it was a bit boring, and I was just trying to understand, and why has he written all these things, and why do I care about these things? So I was like, okay, now that I have got the book, and it was during the lockdown. So I thought, okay, no problem. I have a book, and I do not have other books because I couldn't order the books because again of the lockdown. So I thought, yes, I will, you know, soldier through it and read it. And that was among the best decision that I took, because that introduced me to Gladwell and his books, and he is so amazing. I loved it. So before reading this book, I used to read, but not that much, and I was not that into books. The book that I had really liked before reading this book was The Power of Habit, and that was again because there were so many interesting concepts and so many real life examples that I was very interested and thrilled and really amazed after reading that book. And then I came across this, and this was just next level stuff. And so this book was the tipping point in my reading journey, and really it tipped me over the edge, and I've been reading ever since. In this book, he explains how things tip, how pandemics start, how revolution starts, not pandemic like corona, but you know, like the pandemic of information, or how brands really viral their products, and you know, all these things. On the outward, it all seems so simple. We are so quick to judge that, okay, they are just making the product, they are selling it. We can't see what efforts they are putting into their product, what all they are doing to make that a success. And when I read what all people do to make their products a success, what all they do to sell their product, and you know, just how much thought people put in little things, that really inspired me and motivated me. And I was like, whenever I'm going to do something, I'm going to put in, at least I'm going to try to put in equal thoughts into it. And it was just amazing, you know, reading this book and reading about it. It was fascinating. And one important reason for that is the way he writes. It does not go in chronological order, that okay, this happened, then this was the reason, then this happened, and you know, it all goes. It's not like that. He unfolds each and everything at the right time. So it's not a non-fiction, it's not a simple non-fiction book where he will just present you a problem and the solution. He actually takes you on a journey, he takes you on a ride, and he uncovers each and everything at the right time, and you are just totally into the book, and you are enjoying it, you are thrilled by it, and you are just loving it all together. Oh my god, this is amazing. I ordered his another book, Outliers, right after reading this one, because it was so amazing, and just I was totally hooked. I was totally into the book, and yes, one of the best book that I have read till date. I still remember how I felt while reading this, and it was one. I was totally thrilled. I was totally blown away by this book. I might be overhyping it, because this was my first Gladwell, and this was the first time I read a book like this. So it was no comments on that. I love him. I just love him. So right after reading this one, I ordered this another book, Outliers by him, and this turned out to be amazing too, and even more amazing than that one. This was so good, and the writing was much easier than the previous one. So what he has said in this book is, he's talked about many successful people and how they got success, and also about unsuccessful people and why did not they get the success. So you know, our culture makes us feel that if a person is successful, then that person has worked hard, that person has tried, and if someone is not successful, then we call that person a failure, and we are like, he's not trying hard enough, he is not giving his all. But that's not all. Hard work can be one of the points which gives you success, but it's not all. There are many other factors which are not in our control, which really controls where we go in life, like our environment, the place where we are brought up, how our parents are born, the time that we are born, the things that are going on in the environment at that time. So there are a lot of factors which determine the success, and this book really humbles you. It really does. It makes other people who are successful, who have achieved a lot, like Bill Gates. So even his example is given, how he has achieved that. It really, you know, put things into perspective and motivates you and humbles you reading his book always feels like an adventure. It's like you are on a journey and you are going to uncover a lot of new things, and that exactly what he offers, and he never disappoints. So yes, he is amazing and I love all his books. Out of three, if I have to suggest you one book that you should definitely read or you should just pick up right away, then this will be the book Outliers, because it is really enlightening. It is going to open up your eyes. It is a must read for everyone, especially for college students, young graduates, or people who are trying to make in life. So when you read it, you will gain a lot of perspective. This is going to be a very essential read for you all, and I'm sure you are going to take away something really good, and it will really, you know, give you the perspective, give you that mindset to move ahead. And yes, I think this is going to be really amazing, and I would suggest it to you all, definitely. All the young graduates, college students, people who are working right now, who have started working recently. So, you know, reading this book will really give you that perspective that you need. Almost right after this one, I ordered his third book, and that is this one, Talking to Strangers. I had seen this book a lot in bookstores because this was recently released when I bought it. So I was seeing this everywhere, and the title was really intriguing, Talking to Strangers. I was like, you know, what is going on here? I might find something really nice, something very interesting from this book. As I said, you know, more than the content or more than the topic, obviously his research is amazing. The way he researches each and every topic, dives deep, and you know, interview people and learn about facts and talk to different people about it, and then, you know, all that information he weaves it into a book. And his research is obviously amazing, but the way he writes, you know, each and everything uncovers, and it feels like you are uncovering them all. It feels like you are, you know, you are the one who's finding out these things. You are the one who's figuring out these things. So it's really amazing the way he writes. I am a fan. So just ignore my gushing over him. I can't help it. I'm really trying, but I just can't help it. So again, this book was pretty amazing. So in this book, he has given like really, really amazing examples. He has shown how even the jury makes a mistake, or how trained people like spies, or, you know, people who are trained to know that other person is lying, even they can't make out that whether the person is telling the truth or lie. Then how can we normal people know what the other person is thinking, or whether the person, whatever the person is saying, is honest or not? In this book, he has talked about how we talk to strangers, how we perceive them, and what errors do we make. He has talked about a lot of important issues, a lot of social issues also in this book. And you know, some of the things will really blow up your mind and even horrify you at times. You know, some of the examples that he has taken, those examples are not just examples, those are the real incidents, things that have happened. And you know, how we default to the truth, how we tend to believe the other person unless we have enough reasons not to. He says there was just something lacking in this book, but if you are a new reader, if you have not read his other books, then you are just going to totally enjoy, totally love it. Because if I have to give this book a little less rating, that's because I know his standard. I have read his other books and I know how great he can be. But if you have not read his other books and if you are picking this up, you are going to be amazed. You are going to enjoy it. You are going to thoroughly enjoy it. And you are going to be like, you know, it's just the way he writes, and he tells you, he takes you on a journey, and you are going to be thrilled. You are going to be amazed. Believe me on that. So pick up a book by him. Pick up any book by him. And it is going to be great. These are the only three books that I have of his, and I'm thinking of ordering another one super soon. So, but I'm really confused on which one to pick next. I have heard a lot good things about Blink, but I have heard equally good about What the Dog Saw as well. And then there's this another book by him, David and Goliath. So I'm very confused on which one to get next. So yeah, please help me out here. If you have read any other book by him, and if let me know how you liked it, if you liked it, and what are your thoughts on them. So, you know, help me make a decision, help me make an informed decision, so I can pick up very amazing that he is, you know, just a great book by him, and read it and have a great time. Thank you for watching this video.